Hello and welcome to the top four match of the General Games League for Star Wars Destiny. I'm Marcus Mailer. I'm in the booth here with Matt Curtis.
Hi guys, I've just been summarily ushered out of the competition.
Yeah, we previously saw Matt play against Kirk in the top eight match, and it was a great game to watch. It was an enjoyable best of three. I only went to two matches, but both were two games rather, but both were well played.
Well, that's a kind lie that you're telling me. But...
No. Definitely played well. Will be some great viewing. Definitely a good indication of how to play both decks very well. Anyways, so on to this match. We have Kirk Paul Smart versus Arthur Segoitis.
Yeah, now the Kylo Dooku deck, the strength of it, as I understand it, I haven't actually played the matchup, is its flexibility. Like, they both have a lot of value on all sides of their dice.
Yes.
You get four good value dice, and then you just go where the dice take you.
Yeah, basically. It's a deceptive deck in that it can pump out a large amount of damage, but it can also play the control role. It has some very strong blue control cards, blue upgrades, which will control the board.
That's right. You get the full blue villain control suite, which is terrific. Oh, early deflect.
Yep. So there's straight away we see the deflect there, one of the stronger cards in the deck, obviously, in this matchup. Kirk obviously playing the same list that he was playing in the previous match. So the flavor of the month, I guess, I think is accepted as one of the strongest decks currently going around, obviously, is the Jango Trooper Balotic.
Of all the Jango decks, it's certainly got the most play and is probably very, if not the strongest, very close to the strongest.
So, discards the Fight Dirty early.
Look, it's a great finisher. I don't think you want to waste it opening up as
yourself. Yeah, makes sense.
Oh, both deflects in hand, something we both missed.
Nice. Yep. Didn't take that close of a look at the hands here. So that's something to note, obviously, being that Arthur will not have a deflect later in the match, firing them both off very early.
So whilst it might feel frustrating being deflected twice, this is actually Kirk's dream. He now doesn't have to worry about
does
it
not
anymore.
Does not have to play around that card for the remainder of the match. So Arthur chooses to resolve just a one melee there. Interestingly enough, going after after Jango first.
Look, I think that's probably right. He's not as vulnerable to the Balotic triggers because he's got two fairly healthy characters, and Jango has the non-redeployable jetpack on him. It's just good to get him out.
Yeah, definitely. I think he's just following the upgrade here, and I tend to agree with you. Interesting to note that the battlefield that was chosen is the Emperor's Throne Room. Now, I'm not sure actually who won the role, but regardless, that is the battlefield that's being played with. Now, that is turn a die to a side showing a special and then resolve it.
Yeah, so I didn't pay enough attention in the opening of this match, but it's interesting to note that Kirk's discarded and on the hunt, which I would have thought would be great to be in play, given that the battlefield's Emperor's Throne Room. It's controllable mitigation every day.
I think right now he's discarded purely to pump through damage. I mean... this deck is foot to the floor from the first turn to the last. All you want to be doing is hitting as much damage as you possibly can be.
Kylo connecting for zero at Kirk's dream.
Yep. Kylo's special is something to consider when playing cards and the order in which you play cards and what you discard and what you keep and so on, but definitely something that is not that hard to play around.
Absolutely. Arthur has to consider whether or not Kirk's sandbagging high-cost cards that he can't get out into the battlefield.
Yep.
But Kirk is going to happily discard anything that costs two or more from his hand.
Yep, so Arthur hits a nice start there, gets the holocron in play, resolves it, manages to get the force choke into play without paying upgrade costs. Quite strong. Bit of damage there. I think it's just one damage on Kylo. So
I'm trying to tell if that's one or four, but I think it's just one.
I believe it's just one. The card's got a very red patch on it. So Arthur, obviously, it looks like Arthur claimed and immediately plays out the holocron on Dooku, trying to get Dooku as big as possible.
Well, second jetpack, double jetpack for a melee deck.
Kirk calls with the jetpack. Now Arthur rolls in Kylo, hits a special, and it looks like a shield.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Kirk pondering as to whether or not he wants to roll in Jango here, considering whether or not he wants to play an upgrade or something first. So the only reason not to roll in Jango, obviously, in response immediately would be whether or not you wish to play an upgrade. Now, he obviously elects not to, wants to hold off on that.
Oh, the dreaded plus twos.
So hits the middle of the tree on the jetpack there with the plus two, and the plus two on Django. Oh, sorry, rather on Balotic's base die. Not unhappy. There's a lot of guns on the other two characters, so those could quite easily be resolved.
Is almost impossible to stop those modifiers taking place
Yeah.
with.
So Arthur resolves the Kylo special.
And hitting dug in, I think. So he now knows Kirk has it. It was dug in or tactical mastery?
I think it might have been the attack mastery hit, but no, of note, Kirk does have both in hand.
All right. Dodge seems well played at this point in time.
Yes, yep, very well placed dodge there. Arthur would have just been sitting on that, waiting for Kirk to roll any kind of base range damage, and would have
Yeah,
just,
and happily sweep him all the
yep,
way.
fired that off immediately. So rolls in Dooku.
So we've got crush resources, a focus,
Whoa.
and oh, all the damage.
So two damage, focus and crush.
And Django responding in kind with plenty of damage of his own. Is
Yeah.
that hard to
Yeah.
tell if that's plus three on the
That's
jetpack?
a plus three, I do believe. Oh, it might be the two. Hard to know. We'll see.
Dice definitely running hot.
Yes, both sides of the table rolling very well here. Cannot be unhappy. So the turn currently on Kirk, after rolling in Django in response to Dooku.
Gonna deal the five to Kylo.
Elects to go after Kylo. Now, it's interesting. Against this mono blue deck, you have the choice at the beginning of the match whether or not you're going to choose to go after Kylo, which arguably is the easy character kill, or whether you're going to put the pressure on the deck, go after Dooku, and force them to have to decide which cards are most important to them. Obviously, Dooku's ability being able to discard a card to gain a shield when you would take damage. I personally have found that I think going after Dooku can make the deck a lot harder to play. It's much harder for the mono blue player to do everything they want to be doing
If they're
whilst
pitching.
if they're pitching cards.
Absolutely. And certainly the way Dooku seems to work is it's such a powerful disincentive to attack him
Yes.
that the opposition will frequently just put that off till later because it's mentally difficult.
Yes.
And
And I'm of the mindset that you want to be doing it when your characters are at their strongest. Because, I mean, look, Kylo's strong, but his dice aren't that much better than Dooku's. And Dooku is the one that's going to be getting the upgrades.
that's right. And as you say, it's best to pressure Dooku when they don't want to be discarding
Yeah.
it. Once Dooku's got three upgrades and they're happy to pitch their whole hand to save
Yeah.
him, it's much tougher going.
Yeah, exactly. At that point, it's every time you do damage, they're going to be pitching cards. Whereas in the early game, they're much less likely to want to be discarding those cards that they would like to be playing.
That's right. Like, so if we look at Arthur's hand at the end of last turn, he had Mind Probe, Isolation and Use the Force. Like, you don't really want to pitch any of
No,
those cards.
yeah, exactly. You want to hold on to those. You want to be able to get those in play with the Holocron. You want to be able to use the Force to either defend or aggressively do some damage.
Kirk just following in trend and just
Oh,
rolling nothing but guns.
that's a hits the 2 1 and sixes on the Balotic die for the base damage,
Yeah.
and hits the plus three.
Just
That
mitigate this.
is the maximum. Well,
Like, it's the most uninterruptible.
yes, it is. Not to forget the fact here that Arthur has done some serious damage to Django here. I mean, Django's down to two health.
Yes, both sides have come out of the gates fast.
Now, also of note, Kirk very aggressively claimed the battlefield that last turn. Very clearly wants to be firing off that dug in.
Yes, that's a good call.
Yeah. He knows that it's very likely that Django could be taking lethal damage on this turn quite easily.
And he just wants to make it as hard as possible, I
Definitely
think.
wants to make it as difficult as possible. So right now, considering his options, so he rolled in response to Dooku. Now, Dooku is presenting lethal damage. That is the two showing on Dooku there is enough to kill Django. So Kirk's options right now is whether or not to fire off a dug in or try and play a little bit more. I
Yeah,
guess.
he also has the option to kill Kylo before Kylo rolls in, and so he's worried about what mitigation Arthur might have
Yeah,
and
of
what's
course.
best. Do I
Yeah, of
take
course.
bank the damage?
Yep, considers that gets a, plays
Oh,
maybe the
he doesn't like it. That just maybe that's just better than what we were.
It might be better. But I mean the dug in there, holding on to the he doesn't like you and then playing the dug in. It's either that or the line he took, which is he doesn't like you and then dug in. I feel this is probably the better line because it forces Arthur to re-roll, which he has done.
I agree. It feels like the better line to me because what are you hoping to get rid of later on that's going to be better than lethal damage here?
Yep. Still an issue here. Hits the special on the force stroke. Now, that is one unblockable damage, so that will put...
And it potentially turns the +3 of the jetpack to a zero.
Yeah. Well, if he chooses to use it on Balotic. So if he wants the unblockable damage, so it is turn a die attached to that character to any side.
That's right, but one damage won't kill Django.
Won't kill Django, but it will put him in range of Force Stroke next turn.
So he's certainly taken that line.
Yep. So let's just take I've just been sent through Arthur's exact list of cards, so we'll just see what he's working with here and what he has in mind. Now,
well,
I know
Arthur may play Intimidate, which...
Yes.
Hopefully we'd seen his deck list, and so...
Definitely a card that he would... I mean, in the mono blue list, it definitely feels like a card that you would... that would definitely see play.
I would certainly play it.
I play as a one-off in my Vader deck.
Yeah, to me, that card reads, for zero cost, deal a minimum of two damage, so...
Yep. So... He is playing...
He's ushered Kylo out the back door.
Yep, so Kylo...
Against the reactivation on Bala.
Yep.
Well done not to forget that.
Yeah, so plays a one of Intimidate in the list. Plays two No Mercies. A very active card in the mono blue list.
Yes.
So
one of the strongest reasons to play mono blue.
Very often you're pitching your entire hand, you're buffing a melee die by four.
That's right, and you're just finishing someone off.
Yep, it's a lot of damage. So this turn has still been interesting. So Dooku has...
We get the mind probe out.
Does he have the resource to roll it in?
I can't tell. Are those two resources at the top of the screen?
Yeah, I believe. In play? Not sure, actually. I feel if they were, he probably would have chose to roll in the... No, they must be in play.
Kirk's got the resources to activate the troopers. Two for one, and then the jetpack with the +3 behind. And modified damage is clearly the best way to take Dooku down.
You want a one base with three modifiers. You know, that it gives them the opportunity to discard only one card.
That's right.
So it looks as if Arthur's passed there, I believe. Did he pass? Using...
Yeah, he must have.
Interesting. Yeah, he claimed. So he claimed did not... Didn't want to resolve the one damage on the die.
And didn't want to roll in the mind probe die?
So, no, actually, of course, no. He would have claimed use the ability in order to get the mind probe in play.
Oh, yes.
So, he would use the Emperor's Throne Room ability on the Holocron to get it in play. That makes perfect sense. Guarantees him next turn to be able to roll in with a mind probe, an incredibly threatening card. A lot of potential damage there.
I have underestimated that card. It just shows damage on like at least three of its sides that are just so heavy.
Yep. So Kirk resolves some damage. Arthur discards. So
things looking very tough for Dooku at this point.
Yeah, interesting that turn. I believe there was no damage on Dooku at the time he claimed, and he finishes that turn on six. Kirk demonstrating what this deck can do.
Yes, just the damage it's pumping out.
If left unhindered, it's playing solitaire and it's pumping out a lot of damage.
Yeah, and worth noting, he's only got the two upgrades in play, and it has just been
two of the
very effective,
arguably the best ones in the deck.
Yes.
If all you want to do is pump out damage, there is few upgrades better than two jetpacks.
Certainly, jetpack feels slightly above the
curve, and as we can see here, demonstrated by. The
yet more base plus modifier.
Yeah, base modifier.
Mind probe with discard there.
So hits the mind probe special. No, it doesn't.
And the force choke special.
Hits the force choke special, but not the mind probe. So that's the two disrupt.
But certainly presenting the ability to just empty Kirk's hand.
Yeah, definitely.
Which robs him of rerolls, which would be a problem if Kirk just didn't roll damage.
That's a lot of damage. So that's a plus two and a plus two and a one, I believe.
That is definitely lethal.
So, look, that's lethal.
And we get the handshake.
Yep, so that's game one. Look, Arthur... Yeah,
not sure what he could have done differently.
No, exactly. Yeah. Kirk was hitting damage. Arthur wasn't able to push through that final point of damage to finish off Dooku. Django. Very well played by Kirk to, you know, make the most of the fact that Django was still in the game.
Kirk definitely identified that his early rolls were strong, yep, and that it is now just a race to see, mm-hmm, who can pump out the most damage. And at that point, he didn't care what he discarded just to maximize his damage potential.
Yeah, definitely. Just choosing to
presented Arthur with the sort of fait accompli that he had no choice but to race as well, but he doesn't race nearly as effectively.
No.
And he just didn't get enough control. No. And worth noting that Kirk pushed through both deflects and...
Yeah.
Just, there was, yep, no slowing him down.
So, two deflects. I mean, look, two deflects in your opening hand against this deck feels very strong, but possibly a little deceptive, in that I feel, yes, that the card's probably better safe for the times when you want to, you know, take away the base from the jetpacks and such.
Absolutely. And it also gains value when your opponent's playing around it because they're a bit too cautious.
Yes, exactly. Not having to even consider the card for the entirety of the game means that Kirk can play a little bit more, caution to the wind, re-roll a little bit more aggressively, leave modifiers in play and re-roll for the single base as opposed to having to consider the fact that he might be getting deflected, so re-rolling to try and hit two bases instead of one. Definitely changes the way in which your opponent would play the match.
Absolutely, and knowing Kirk, that's the type of play he likes. Once he has to stop playing around things and he can just maximize, yep, his damage potential,
yep,
he loves that moment.
Yeah, exactly. I think anybody playing this deck really appreciates the ability to just roll dice. It's what the deck does best.
That's right.
Your cards have a split purpose. Obviously, in any deck, you know, you can choose to discard to reroll, but in this deck...
The damage ceiling is so high.
Exactly. You feel much more rewarded when you do that as opposed to other decks when you're doing it just to try and find something relevant.
That's right. Like, all the dice are likely to result in damage if you re-roll them two or three times.
Yeah, definitely. All right, so Mulligan's happening. It looks like Kirk's kept maybe one card. Arthur's kept, I think, two.
Yep.
Again, this is match play. So that was round. That was game one of the best of three match. So
if you were Arthur, what would you be hoping to see in your opening hand, do you think?
Look, against this deck, in the mono blue deck, you want to see a Holocron. You want to see a Holocron and something to play off of it. It's very important that you're going to be taking damage. You will be taking damage early.
Yep.
You just need to keep up. So the faster you can get three upgrades in play on Dooku, the better.
I totally agree. I think you want to start with a Holocron and an upgrade, like you say, and turn two, you want to see your No Mercy and hopefully finish someone off.
Just pop someone early. So Arthur obviously losing game one of the match means it's assumed that he won the die roll for game two.
That's right. He gets the choice, quickly picks his own, and Kirk cleverly splits the shields.
Look, I mean, given that Arthur did decide game one to go after Django, Kirk doesn't want to overcommit to putting the shields both on Django and then Arthur cleverly go after Balotic instead.
Yeah.
So he just, you know, hedges his bets. One on both seems fine.
Slightly frustrating to Arthur, who is holding the Intimidate.
Yes, exactly. Or maybe we're not giving Kirk enough credit. Maybe he's literally just playing around the Intimidate.
Look, perhaps that's right. Kylo showing his special, which is very good in this matchup, but not so perfect in this matchup.
No, not great in this matchup, but definitely some cards worth hitting in Kirk's hand. I mean, he could hit the Thermal Detonator. I believe he has a 2-cost in there as well.
And look, the information alone is not nothing. All right, so that's unfortunate.
Unlucky. So
revealing unpredictable, look, obviously
Arthur,
dealing no damage.
Arthur definitely wanted to fire that off then. I mean, Kirk rolled in Django, resolved the resource immediately. Arthur knows something's up. Arthur knows he has something big in his hand.
That's right.
Thermal detonator. Thermal detonator hits play.
Arthur now knows what he was looking for.
Yep, wanted to hit that card. Kylo's still showing 2 damage for a resource. As well as now Dooku showing 2 damage as well.
Who do you go for here?
Look, I'm still a fan of always going up. I feel it's correct in this list to go after Baltic no matter what. Generally speaking, you're removing two dice, you're removing the reroll ability. The focuses are very relevant. He's easier to kill, arguably, than Django.
Absolutely.
And I feel you get more reward when he dies.
Look, in general, I think that's correct. I think you want to kill Baltic.
Yep.
The line is blurred somewhat depending where the shields go and where the upgrades go.
Of course, yeah, definitely. I mean, like, if your opponent opens up with double jetpack, you know, jetpack into jetpack onto, say, Django,
and your choice,
you're definitely, your mind's made up for you. But given the choice between the two, I feel that Baltic is generally the correct one.
We have to say both players sitting on control, Kirk, yep, having the he doesn't like you in isolation for Arthas.
Yep. So uses the he doesn't like you on the somewhat redundant, somewhat unnecessary discard of the thermal detonator to just take away Arthur's ability to do 4 damage instead, forcing him to have to do 2.
Yeah, Kirk not needing to blow up the grenade now, happy to extract value from it.
Yep.
Over a few turns.
Yeah, definitely.
And just slowing down all the damage he can.
Yep, it's a threat. It's a threat. I mean, 6 damage when you hit the special is huge. So Kirk rolls in the trooper, hits...
Arthur sitting on both the flex again.
Hits a resource. Chooses to fire off the double discard here. Not a terrible decision, I feel, against this deck. It's the best defense and, I believe, an unpredictable.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. I would be very happy to see those cards go.
Very strong. Very strong.
Kirk pitching a flank, so you're already through almost half of the...
And immediately...
just rolls damage.
Yeah, it just hits the base, hits the modifier.
Just living the life.
It feels rough, doesn't it? I mean, look, Arthur made the correct play, I feel, there. Forcing your opponent has 3 cards in hand, forcing them to discard 2, meaning they're left with a single reroll.
Absolutely. Arthur would have sold his kingdom for a single resource there to deflect that base.
Yes. Unfortunately.
But there are no breaks in Destiny.
Nope. So damage is resolved. So 4 damage onto
Kylo.
Onto Kylo, game 1. Oh, sorry, round 1. 2 damage showing onto Django. Overall, relatively fair exchange. I mean, Kirk's damage ceiling is much higher than 4.
Yes. That's right. Like, getting off fairly lightly.
Yeah, definitely. So rolls in, hits 2 blanks there, which is not what you want to be seeing.
and Arthur didn't develop his board at all, which is not the start.
No, definitely not.
You just lose ground every turn.
Didn't see any upgrades in his opening. I think he kept 2 cards.
Went looking.
Didn't manage to find any. So there's the deflect.
The first deflect comes out.
It's the one there.
Look, taking Django up to 3.
Yeah, look, I mean, maybe firing it off a little bit prematurely there. Kirk's going to be re-rolling.
Look, he's got 2. I think he can get rid of both bases this turn and then just hope to just pressure Kirk.
Yeah, the timing on when you deflect is so relevant, though. I mean, because, again, now, so Arthur's used both his deflects. He has no resources left. Kirk now knows for the rest of the game he doesn't have to play around deflects. And right now, he's stopped 2 damage with 2 cards. It's not a trade I feel worth it.
Look, it is tough. Like, if you wait for the perfect position, perhaps the accumulation of damage is just too much.
So, Kirk firing off the thermal detonator there. 3 damage across both characters.
Yes, just the 6 damage feels crippling.
It is a lot of damage.
Arthur pitching force choke to reduce the damage.
Yep. Interesting. Yeah, see, I mean, so instead of playing a force choke out there and developing his board, he decided to deal 2 damage and prevent 2 damage. I mean,
it's probably not the line I would have
taken. Look, I feel that maybe you want, like, in this situation, you really need to be trying to get cards in play.
Look, it's a very tough call because say you tap out and you play your 2, you pay your 2 resources and you develop the force choke. Kirk now knows you have nothing you can do at this moment, and sometimes he can just roll 8 damage.
But now would be, in my opinion, now's the best time to do it. I mean, Kirk has no upgrades in play. I mean, Kirk's damage is all vanilla damage.
I totally agree. If there's a time, now is the time. It can feel very awkward.
Yeah, of course. It can feel rough. You can feel like you just need to prevent the damage, or, you know. But when it comes down to it, you know, this is a bare knuckle fist fight between 2 decks. I mean, neither deck has upgrades in play, but I know who I take in the ring.
Yeah, look, Arthur trying to seeming to have no choice but to brawl it out with Kirk's deck, and this is not the matchup he wants.
No, definitely not. This is not the matchup you want to be. You want to be just relying on your character dice.
Going to use Dugo's dice to focus Kylo's. What side do you think you'll pick? The special?
I mean, the special presents...
Or just max sticks.
I think maybe just sticks here.
Oh, no. The resource.
This is the resource.
He's got isolation in hand.
Also already showing a two for one there.
Yep.
Kirk just immediately...
Taking no time, just...
Yeah. Electroshocks that immediately. I mean, essentially, Electroshock just removed two dice.
Absolutely.
You know, focus was used. So Kirk immediately claiming the battlefield.
So Kirk has the option of rolling for more damage there, but actually he just wants to steal the march and keep Arthur under pressure.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, look, this is definitely a deck you want to you want to play with. You want to be on the play as often as possible. You know, have the ability to play an upgrade or roll in a character so that when they make their first action, and, you know, you're ahead already.
And given how much damage Kylo's got, I assume Kirk is thinking, if I have first action, I can get an upgrade on Jango and perhaps just kill Kylo before he has a chance to do anything.
Yep. Yeah, look, this is a pretty... a bit of a war of attrition right now. I mean, both decks...
All right, I'm a bit surprised by the gun on Bialetic. Obviously, Jango's taken some damage, but I would have thought Kirk would have backed himself to...
Maybe. I mean, at some point, I think you just accept that Jango being alive is enough of a threat. That gun doesn't have redeploy. I mean,
Kirk's betting on the fact that he's getting the double activation off Bialetic this turn, which with backup muscle in hand seems quite.
Yeah, likely. Of course, and obviously, as you say, the reactivation on Bialetic is, you know,
Kylo just rewarding Arthur when he needs it most.
Mm.
The double blank.
A double blank twice. That's unfortunate. Jango rolls in, sees the
melee damage,
the melee side. Cracking out the knuckle dusters there. So Kirk's legitimate action is going to be rolling Bialetic.
He's got to get those dice in the pool before Kylo dies.
Yep. Yeah. Look, all he's trying to do now is kill Kylo. Probably with Bialetic, and then roll Bialetic in again, get a bunch more damage through. Look, this demonstrating what this deck can do. I mean,
absolutely.
Look, immediately resolves the one damage there. No reason to hold on to it.
And he's got the focus to turn Jango to a 2 if necessary.
Yep. He only needs as it stands currently, he can deal 1 damage from Jango, putting Kylo on 1 damage, and then just kill him with the backup muscle that's already in play.
Absolutely.
Which is quite terrifying when you consider now. Uses the Tact Mastery to just kill him. Stands up Bialetic. Now Bialetic in play is able to resolve both of his dice.
That's right. Those dice aren't lost yet. Absolutely.
So, I mean, look, this seems great. I mean, Kirk has so many choices here. I mean, he can focus the gun that's in play. He can just gain a shield, focus the trooper die. Like,
he's doing the happy dance in his head. So many ways for this to go right.
Look, he's right now he's just coming up with the ways in which he feels he can do the most damage.
And Arthur just feeling the misery, staring at his hand.
Yeah, you know, look.
What do I do in this position? Dooku has no upgrades.
Yeah, look, that's the problem. The way the match panned out, Dooku never got a lightsaber, Dooku never got a force choke, force throw.
I feel like Arthur maybe was waiting to see Holocron and then hasn't decided he's not going to get it this game and made the hard choices.
Yeah, look, I mean, like, he's looking at it binds all things in hand.
Pitches force throw for a reroll.
Pitches the force throw. Like, just never able to get enough of what the deck wants to be doing.
Yes.
Just doesn't get there, unfortunately. And Kirk demonstrating why you can't brawl it out with this list. Yeah, so Kirk rolls in. Doesn't have the resource to resolve that. Doesn't matter. Has the focus on Bialetic if he chooses to do it that way. Arthur's got to be feeling pretty...
Yeah, look, he's got the melee damage on Dooku's dice, which he's resolving now, but it just feels too little.
4 damage onto...
I think it was 2.
One and one. You're right, both the singles. So 2 damage onto Jango. Now, Kirk...
Going to focus up the trooper to the
focus
2.
Focus up the trooper. I mean, all he needs to play around here really is isolation, but I think he's hedging his bet, or he's betting here that Arthur doesn't have it, and if he does, so what? He's going to get to re-roll Bialetic anyway.
That's right. He's asking the question, And I imagine he's looking to cash in that shield on Jango and just make it even tougher. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, look, so he gets to claim that shield.
Oh. Perhaps Kirk thinking it was damage and not checking.
Yeah, interesting. Interesting. Tried to give his opponent a shield.
Yep.
Very kind. Legal within the rules.
That's right.
The rules for shield on dice is give a character a shield.
Yeah, does not specify. It must be your own.
Interesting. I have had it come up in games where it's been the correct plan to give an opposing character a shield and then hit them with a Kylo Saber.
Yes.
definitely feels quite rewarding when that pays off.
Arthur spending both resources to dodge there, it just feels like a mistake.
Yeah, look.
Of all the damage Kirk can show, that was very little.
Yeah, that was the smallest amount.
And if you don't develop, you die.
I mean, Kirk right now he's just gonna re-roll.
Yeah,
all those cards in his hand are just
Arthur waving the white flag.
Ways to re-roll. Chooses to resolve the resource to play the second backup muscle. Look, it's all gravy for Kirk. I mean, it's hard for him to do anything wrong at this point.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Look,
Arthur in deep misery.
yeah. Like Arthur's going to look at this video, I feel.
Holding a Kylo Saber and it binds all things.
Just a bunch of cards that just do nothing at this point in the game. They're things you need early.
Picks up No Mercy, which might be good to finish Jango off.
Yeah, but at the cost of losing your hand, and then you've got a Bile Tick and a... Basically, you've got an unhindered trooper and Bile Tick ready to take you out.
Look, absolutely, but you have to start killing people and you've got to play to your outs.
Yeah.
Who knows? Maybe Kirk will just see no damage for a change.
Yeah, I mean, look, I think this match isn't completely indicative of the deck or Arthur's play. I mean, look, this is the top four.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, clearly Arthur knows what he's doing. Clearly Arthur plays very well.
All players have proved themselves.
Yeah, definitely. I think maybe just one or two less than favorable hands and just the pressure of what Kirk's playing and it's just put him on the back foot.
Absolutely. And Kirk starting fast. And
yeah, definitely.
And just sucking the time out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Definitely being very rough.
Immobilize, I originally thought was not very good, but in the control decks is actually amazing.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, look, Immobilize is one of those cards that has a place in certain decks, I feel, but is definitely not an auto-include in every blue deck.
Absolutely. It was difficult to evaluate at first. Yeah. I certainly was not impressed.
It's something you want to be doing, you know, when your opponent's got no resources and when they've discarded a few cards to reroll. Being able to simply blank a die is so powerful.
Absolutely. And as you say, in the right deck, it's cumulative control.
Yeah, so definitely.
It's just another element.
Yeah, it's one of those things. It definitely...
So I know in the Vader Jabba deck, it immobilizes very strong.
Oh, incredibly strong. I mean, your opponent, you know, you're pulling cards from their hand, you're forcing, like, you know, what the strongest thing you can do on board is if your opponent's got no cards in hand, turn one of the, just change the face of one of their dice, and suddenly what do they do?
That's right. Like, Force Choke and Immobilize so effective in a deck that attacks the hand.
Yeah, of course. So, Arthur's here, rolled up two damage on...
Kirk showing no gun base, but has the focus.
Fires
there.
Off the No Mercy. I think that should be enough to kill.
Yeah, yep.
Yep, going for what he can here.
That's
enough
right.
To kill off Jango. But look, now...
Certainly, that's the right place to start.
Yeah, look, I mean, you got to make inroads somehow. Left with one card in hand.
And Kirk not knowing it, that it's essentially a blank.
Complete blank. I mean, it's not that relevant anyway. He's got no money left.
Yes.
Kirk's just going to have his way now. Look, I imagine all of those cards in Kirk's hand going to be re-rolled. He's showing two damage on board simply from the backup muscles. And potentially a lot more. I mean, even with the sides currently showing, I mean, that's a +2/+2. Focus of Baltic die. That's five damage on board.
Arthur must have claimed because Kirk's just taking multiple actions.
Yep. And that's
it. And that's the handshake.
That's lethal.
Yep.
Look, that was rough. That was really rough.
Yes.
Kirk demonstrating how to play that deck well.
Very effective.
Yep. Making the correct plays at the right time, you know, re-rolling opportunistically. Arthur just just on the back foot from turn one.
Yeah, both games, very rough. Kirk getting good rolls initially,
yep.
identifying that this is now his plan to pressure early and making the correct decisions, and just Arthur feeling like he was always reacting.
Yeah, yeah. Look, Arthur was never proactively in that match, unfortunately, which is definitely what that deck wants to be doing. Commiserations to Arthur.
Yes, congratulations. I certainly know how that feels.
Congratulations to Arthur at the same time for making it this far. That's put him, you know, he'll finish, this is the top four, so he'll finish at least fourth.
That's right.
Cannot be unhappy with that result. Some great prizes support in this tournament.
Yeah, it's been a great league. We've had a number of rounds. It's been terrific. And as Marcus says, the prize support is generous.
Yep. Definitely looking forward to playing in the next league myself.
Yes. Do you know what deck you'll be playing?
Well, obviously, I played Vader Raider in this, and I was defeated in the top eight in a series of unfortunate events. But well played to my opponent, who I'm not sure how he's done in the top four. So maybe we'll see him on camera in the next match.
Yeah, we can only hope. I myself played Han Ray through the league, and I will be changing.
Moving on for bigger and better things.
I wanted to give it a goodbye tonight, and I have the regret.
Yeah, fair enough. All right. Well, I'm Marcus, and I've been your commentator with Matt.
And I've been Matt. Thank you for watching.
Yeah, we'll be back with the top, the finals. Stay with us.